My name is Melissa. I'm with Jacobs & Co. Real Estate. I'm here today at Carried to Full Term in Haymarket, Virginia. It's a nonprofit organization that helps women and moms, and they are offered all sorts of tools and assistance with volunteers and professionals who help them get out of situations that they're currently in. I'm really excited to introduce you to some of the people behind the scenes that make this organization what it is, that help moms and women in crisis.
I would rather see this world through the eyes of a child.
I'm here today with Fran Robin. She's the director at Carried to Full Term. She's graciously taken some time today to meet up with us. Where did the creation of Carried to Full Term come from?
I spent many years volunteering at crisis centers for women. And then when my daughter started high school, I saw this need for something more to help them understand themselves. And so I coupled what I saw at the crisis center for women with needing to provide an answer for students at the public school. And so I coupled the two of them under the same name, Carried to Full Term. And out of that came this opportunity to provide housing for women, whether they were students or women at crisis centers needing housing. So Carried to Full Term provides long-term housing for women that are pregnant and homeless. Homelessness is a crisis in and of itself. Pregnancy and homelessness is a trauma. When families have the basic necessity that's a home, that's housing, they can do a lot of things. They can focus on caring for each other. Moms could take the time to just be, rather than always in survival mode, always thinking of what do I need to do for today when night starts coming. At Carried to Full Term, we give them peace of mind.
I'm sure you've helped many women and children. Is there a particular story that is like personal to you, that's been impactful to you?
One mom came, and she came in the middle of the night. She came at midnight. People in her past just influenced her against what she wanted to do. Anyway, she left. But she never left the program emotionally or mentally. And she stayed connected to us. And to this day, I have a very, very, very close relationship with that mom. Even though she didn't finish the program, sometimes that's just what was needed for our lives to intersect. And then we could provide extended support in a variety of ways. So that's just one. But I feel really bad giving that example because I have so many other connections to some of the other moms. One of my baby's upcoming birthday party, and she told me to come dress as a princess, and I said, I would like to come dress as a princess, but it's your birthday. You're gonna be the princess. You know what she said?
Aww.
She said, come dress as the queen.
Oh, I love that.
I know. Okay, I'm having a moment.
You gotta
be a queen. Yes, she said, come dress as a queen, and I told her I'll also come dress with as a queen, and I'll bring a wand as her fairy godmother, and so we will see what magic we'll make at her birthday party.
Tell me about the volunteers, the people that are behind the scenes that help make this work.
They're the glue, they're the machine. We need our volunteers. We need babysitters, we need instructors, we need drivers, we need people to just sit and talk to, we need mentors, we need admins. You across the board, we need our volunteers. They're wonderful. We have nurses, we just have your everyday average person just looking to do something to give back to the community, to do a diaper drive, to just come in and babysit with the moms so that the moms can go to work or go to a doctor's appointment. We just rely heavily on our volunteers.
Every Christmas, we go all out with Christmas decorations. Mm-hmm. And my husband mentioned to me one time, he's like, I do this because I know it brings joy and I know that we get a lot of people to drive by. I would love it if we could actually request people to do a donation. And someone else in my neighborhood had done a drive for you. So I was like, ooh. So I reached out and I got information about what you guys needed. And I was able to put like a wish list, mm-hmm. and I was able to even create one on Amazon so that people could donate. While we do that at Christmas time, what could we be doing year round?
Not only is there not public transportation, but they don't have a means by which to get around. So our workaround for that is Uber cards. And so if we could get them to get Uber so that that way we could reduce the weight on our volunteers to drive a resident to a doctor's appointment around the corner, they could just Uber. If it's raining, if it's snowing, they could Uber to work. They could pick up their children from the daycare. They could go to the doctor's appointment and things like that using Uber cards.
I know you guys have a women's conference coming up. So tell us about that.
It's called Breaking Cycles Women's Conference. Yes, our areas of focus are women with children and women who are pregnant and homeless. But by extension of being in the community of women, they reach out for support. And so the Breaking Cycles Women's Conference will be held on March 25th at George Mason Prince William Campus. I want to underscore.
Yeah.
William Campus at the Verizon Hall. And it's to just focus on, for women to focus on themselves. If we have experience our own medical issues, or if we've experienced loss of any kind, whether it's a baby, you know, through infant loss or a member, whatever the loss is, or just stagnancy or not knowing what to do next, mm-hmm. career-wise, or mourning your sense of self because you've given so much to a relationship, whatever type of relationship that may have been, this conference is for you to connect with other women and to connect with yourself. We just have a wide range of individuals who are very skilled, very talented, to provide as much support as we can to women from across each category. And I know we have our schedules and I know we have our busy lives, but I'm encouraging every woman to like cancel that day because you're worth it.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to meet with us today.
Thank you for having me. I could be here all day.
I know, right? Same. Thank you, Fran.
Thank you. This was wonderful. Thank you.
I'm here with Tiffany Brown. She's an assistant director here at Carried to Full Term. She's taken some time for us today. Why are you here at Carried to Full Term?
I volunteered my photography services here, and I photographed the mothers, newborns, and the maternity pictures. And so I've been doing that. I ended up saying, oh, I can donate some more time, let me do something. So they were like, oh, what's your resume? And I sent my resume, and they're like, well, you never told us that you were in human services. Here's, what about this job? You know, and I'm like, oh, I guess I can do. So it kind of wrapped up, and Fran's so good at wrapping everything with a bow. So it just sounded so great, and being able to work with these women and to assure that they have safety and that the kids are safe. I'm a kids person, so I love seeing the babies. I love seeing and helping and supporting the moms on how to interact and how to raise their children mm-hmm. appropriately.
Tell us about the volunteer opportunities here at Carried to Full Term.
A lot of people, when they come in and they think volunteering is hands-on with the moms, and that is not the case. We have groups that come in and they just want to do yard work. So we have volunteers that donate. We have volunteers that come in and clean. We have volunteers that help out at our events, our gala, our women's conference that's coming up. And we need babysitters. We need drivers. I would recommend contacting directly. There is a form on the site. You can click the volunteer link and you can fill out the form, but sending one of the emails directly, you know, that just will be
a little
better connection.
Now, as far as the women's conference, you do need volunteers.
Yes.
Okay, so if you're looking for a volunteer opportunity, that's coming up in March. So head over to the website and find out how to get in contact or do it online and become a volunteer.
Yeah. So yeah, we need people to kind of shuffle and let's go this way and kind of check in and all that kind of stuff.
And they get to be a part of the conference.
Right. You can go in some of the breakout rooms and listen to the wonderful speakers that we have. So, yeah.
Awesome. I love that.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much,
Tiffany.
This was awesome.